Time for another board game review, and this time we have the game Escape from Iron Gate. This was sent to me by the Escape Game, and it's designed by Theo Hogland. Welcome to Iron Gate Prison. You and your friends have been wrongfully accused of crimes and don't belong behind bars. There's only one path to freedom, a good old-fashioned prison break. The good news, one of you is going to make it out. The bad news, only one of you is going to make it out. Can you act, draw, and solve your way to freedom? Let me show you how to play. So, you're trying to escape from Iron Gate Prison by moving through each of the four areas on the board, from the cell block, to the yard, to the cafeteria, to the warden's office, and finally to freedom. In order to progress to the next area, you gotta turn in certain items, and get items by collecting, or by completing puzzles, drawing, acting, and trading. Whoever gets to the end first wins. Each player starts with three common items in their hand, and they also have secret gold cards. Each step of the way, you gotta trade in certain cards. So to get to the yard, this player needs to collect instant noodles and books. Go to the cafeteria, there's a rare item, rare soap, clothes and cash, and they get harder and harder as the objectives get more complicated. On your turn, you take these dice and you roll them. Now, if you rolled either double A's or double P's, you get to take a lucky card. You just read it. In this case, weighted die. Each player rolls one die. The player with the lowest number wins. And they get to take a free common item. There are things like that. I'll show you a couple other examples. Craps. The first player that rolls sequential numbers loses. Play against the player on your right. Winner gets a common item. They're not all dice ones, but it just so happens. The player with the least amount of items may say any common item. If you have that item, you must give them one of that item. All these sort of random events that can happen with the lucky deck. And then, depending on what you rolled, if I rolled the double A's, I gotta pull out an action card. There are two types, act it and also draw it. Either way, you can pick the difficulty of what you're trying to go for. Regardless of what type of card it is, you have 30 seconds to either act it out silently or draw it. And the game provides you with pencils and paper. Now, if you pick easy difficulty, whoever guesses it, the player with the action card draws a common item. The player who guessed correctly also draws a common item. If you do a medium and they get it right, you draw a rare, they draw a common. And if you do hard, both you get two rare items and give one of them to the guesser. So, with any of these action cards, whether it's acting or drawing, you both share a prize, depending on the difficulty of what you went for. If you do a puzzle card instead, whether it's because you did double P's, or if you roll A and P, you can choose. You don't get a lucky card, but you can choose to do an action or a puzzle card. A puzzle card looks like this. In this case, it's just a puzzle, and you have until your next turn to solve the puzzle. Now, the answer is down here. You can ask for a clue, but if you ask for a clue, you draw a common item card. So the player to your right, if you ask for a clue, they look at it with the decoder, and it says, clue, check the board for a cipher. Ah, okay. And so if you look on the board, well, actually, I won't spoil it for you guys. Oh, you already saw the fucking answer. Whatever. Anyway, so this would be an example of a puzzle. And if you got it without a hint by your next turn, you get to draw a rare item. If you used a clue, draw a common item. Otherwise, nothing happens. Regardless of whether you do a action card or a puzzle card, after completing the instructions, you may then choose one of the following options. You can trade with other players. You can trade items with one player once per turn. You can trade with the commissary. How that works is there's a sort of key here. You can trade any three common items for one common item of your choice, three identical commons for one rare. There's all these different combinations of items you can exchange, and when you do, you discard those cards and you search the decks to get the items you're trying to get. They're all your choice. Yeah, you pick the item you want. There are also specific room trades you can do, depending on what area you're in. For example, soap in the cell block, that always gives you any item of your choice. Rope in the yard, any item. Instant noodles, any item. Depending on the area. So instant noodles in the cafeteria, rope in the yard, flashlight in the warden's office. Those will give you items of your choice as well. Another action you can do is just pass a gate. If you have the correct items for your objective, for example, if my first objective was get instant noodles and books, If I have those items, I can discard them and I can move on to the next area. Otherwise, that's pretty much it. You just try to collect item cards and make it out. I'm not gonna show you too many of these cards. I'll show you a couple more puzzle cards. For example, oh, these are a lot of ciphers. There's different types. There's ones like this. We have to figure out what it's trying to say. There are riddles, you know, all sorts of puzzles in here. And then these are just charades or Pictionary, essentially. Also comes with four dice for the dice-related tasks. And yeah, that's pretty much the game.
I feel like this game's title and presentation are really misleading because this really is not an escape room game by any means. This is just an ultra-light party game. It's not a bad one by any means, but the theming here is very slight. The most fun mechanic in the game are the action cards. They're just, you know, very brief moments of, all right, Pictionary, charades, and everyone gets to participate. It's extremely basic, but I enjoy both of those activities, so, you know, they're fun enough. The puzzle cards are decent puzzles on their own, but as part of a party game, they really don't work. I know strategically it's advantageous to get a puzzle card because then you don't have to share prizes with the guests or you can just get a prize for yourself, but it's substantially less fun. All you do is grab a puzzle card and just kind of look at it and you just wait for your turn to come back. When I played this, everyone always went for action cards because one, it was way more fun and easier to get items. Sometimes the puzzles are just kind of bullshit and you're like, I don't know, and you just sort of, oh, well, that's my turn. You know, no one cares about strategy in a party game. They would just want to have fun. So between the choice of want to play this fun little activity that the group can enjoy, or here's a puzzle that's just for you, the choice is easy. I actually don't mind the silliness of the lucky cards, except there's one dexterity game in there that's fucking terrible. Just a terrible card that just grinds the game to a halt. Also, rolling of dice, you know, I don't mind that. That's goofy and fun. The collecting cards is brainless, but it's a simple way to progress through the game. There's not much thought put into it. And that's kind of how I feel about this whole game. It's not a bad time, but there's not a whole lot of thought put into how it all comes together. Like, the puzzles aren't bad, they're just not executed in a way that is conducive to a party game atmosphere. Either decide, you want this to be a puzzle game or a party game. Not that you can't do both, but this is not the way to do it. Giving someone a solo puzzle to do on their own is not party game. I would have almost preferred the puzzles be like multiplayer, maybe like the first person to get it right, or everybody writes an answer in a time limit and then they reveal at the same time. Or, you know, that could be a much better fit for what this game is going for. All in all, I had an okay time with this. It's not a bad game, but it's the definition of average. There's nothing really special about it. If you want Pictionary or charades, there are much better options out there. It's a very, very just basic experience.